in this month. Now Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam explained this hadith. And who's the narrator? Hazrat Salman. And Salman radiallahu anhu is the longest living sahabi. Not the last sahabi to live. That is Abu Tufail Amir ibn Wathila radiallahu anhu. But the longest living sahabi. And how Allah prolonged his life through the blessings of searching for the truth. Hafidh ibn Hajar rahimahullah says no less than 250 years. So there is a way where Allah blesses a person's lifespan. One of the long living sahabi, sahaba, is the only sahabi to be born in the Kaaba. Who's that sahabi? He lived 60 years in Jahiliyyah and 60 years in Islam. He was Hazrat Khadija radiallahu anha's nephew. What's his name? Who can tell me? He says, whenever he would take a qasam, he would say, Allah, you saved me on the day of Badr. وَالَّذِي نَجَّانِي يَوْمَ بَدْرٍ مَنْ هُوَ قُولُوا لِي. You tell me. Who's that sahabi? The only sahabi born in the Kaaba. There's another report, Ali radiallahu anhu, but that's a weak narration. This is a stronger narration. His mother happened to be in the Kaaba and she fell into labor. That was Hazrat Hakim bin Hizam bin Khuwailid. So Khadija binti Khuwailid. He's also one of the long living sahaba radiallahu anhu. So the longest living sahabi is Hazrat Salman radiallahu anhu. He says, قَدْ أَظَلَّكُمْ. This mighty month has dawned upon you before the month of Ramadan came. So before this month of Ramadan, we have to start getting ready. Don't let it be the month is here and we're not even realizing yet. Let's channel our lives correctly. Let's get onto the highway, on that lane that we have to be on. Let's leave every sin from our life. Let's increase in good deeds already. Let's start our tilawah already as though it's in. Let's just be ready. Let's ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us. This is the time now before the shayateen get tied up. He doesn't want us to do the right thing now. Now he will try and create hatred amongst us. He'll try and create hatred in families. He'll try and create hatred in people so that the month of Ramadan starts sour. We need to ask Allah's extra help. Because before shaitan gets locked up, he tries to do a lot of havoc. And then he's locked up, and then he wants to see after the month of Ramadan what has happened. So this is the time we have to watch our words. Because the fast is not only the fasting of the intake of the mouth. إِذَا لَمْ يَكُنْ فِي الصَّوْمِ مِنِّي تَصَامُمٌ وَفِي مَنْطِقِي صمت وفي مقلتي غض وفي منطقي صمت فحظي إذن من صومي الجوع والظما وإن قلت إني صمت يوما فما صمت. He says if my fast does not have restraint, تصامم, abstaining, watching my words, watching my eyes, guarding my eyesight, guarding my tongue, guarding my limbs from Allah's disobedience, then what's the share that I receive from the fast? It's just hunger and thirst, and it is hot at this time of the year. It's going to be hunger and thirst. So we have to train ourselves properly not to violate this month of Ramadan. So this sahabi narrates, this mighty month has dawned upon you. أَظَلَّكُمْ شَهْرٌ عَظِيمٌ مُبَارَكٌ. A month where in this month there's a night better than 1,000 months. Allah made the fast of this month compulsory. Allah made the standing of the night a prophetic sunnah. Now many make a mistake here. They confuse, and the Salafis try and confuse us more. They confuse the tahajjud of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the taraweeh of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam's tahajjud is every night. That's in Bukhari Sharif. Who narrates the hadith? The blessed wife, Hazrat Aisha Ummul Mu'mineen. She narrates the hadith of his tahajjud. In Ramadan and out of Ramadan, tahajjud. Taraweeh is when? In Ramadan or out of Ramadan? In Ramadan only. Tahajjud, the preferred time, is last part of the night. Taraweeh is the first part of the night. Tahajjud is throughout the year. Tarawih is in the month of Ramadan. As Muslims, we have to aspire to increase. Now the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is sahih. Tahajjud was performed. And Sahaba would also explain his Tarawih, which is also sahih. Hazrat Umar emphasizes the Tarawih in the month of Ramadan. And he is rightfully so, because he is standing behind Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Tarawih. Tarawih is in the masjid. Tahajjud is preferably in the home. So Hazrat Aisha narrates those ahadith. So tahajjud is there. Tarawih is also there. Now the hadith says, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did much more good in Ramadan than out of Ramadan. So can it be possible that he only did 8 out of Ramadan, and in Ramadan he's only doing 8 too? Like some of us after 8, as though we got some disease that we have to run away. We can't exert ourselves to start with the imam and complete with the imam. What about the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reciting the entire Quran to Jibreel alayhi salam? And Jibreel alayhi salam reciting the entire Quran to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the entire Quran being put in the sequence Allah wants it. Put in the sequence Allah wants it in this month of Ramadan. As Jibreel alayhi salam would show Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, surata kada fi mawdi'i kada wa ayata kada fi surati kada. This is clear proof. If Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did much more good in Ramadan, does it make sense that in Ramadan also there's 8 rakat? No, there's 8 which is tarawih, tahajjud. There's much more which is tarawih. And this is we find in the a'imma arba'ah, the fuqaha, they all express this. Are you with me? Even Imam Malik rahimahullah in Medina Munawwara, 36 was performed because there's a competition. In Makkah Mukarramah, there's every 4 rak'at, there's a little break for tasbih, for dhikr. So some people in Makkah would go for tawaf. Then by the time they do a few rounds and the next rak'at starts, so they join in those rak'at. So in Medina Munawwara, just to compete and to become better, in those 4 rak'at, after the 4 rak'at where there was a tarwiha, you know what tarwiha means? It comes from the word raha, just to take a little break. In that period there, in Makkah Mukarramah, they're making tawaf. In Medina Munawwara, they were reading more rak'at. To compete, to become better, not to compete to do less. This is what we have to encourage everywhere in the world and our countries, our masajid. Tarawih must be 20 rak'at. Hazrat Umar would emphasize this. Who was the Imam of Masjid al-Nabawi in the Khilafah of Hazrat Umar? Who can tell me? Correct. Ubay ibn Ka'ab. Aqra'uhum Ubay ibn Ka'ab radiyallahu anhu. But he would read 10. Who would read the other 10? Man al-Imam al-Thani. Qulu li. Hazrat Tamim ibn Awsin al-Dari. Al-Falastini. Al-Dairi. كان لأنه كان صاحب كنيسة كان قسيس. He was a scholar of Christianity. الديري كان له دير. والله وفقه أن يلقى أن لقي الدجال. والله جعل الخير في لقائه الدجال. حتى الدجال سأله عن النبي عليه السلام. دجال asked him about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. That inspired him to go to Medina Munawwara to meet Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he became a Muslim. He embraced Islam 9th year Hijri. So some of the brothers here, mashallah, are old men, mashallah. But you know, Tamim al-Dari was an old man when he embraced Islam. And he learned hard, Sheikh. He learned so hard. He became his title. You know what was his laqab in Medina? What Hazrat Umar used to call him? Khayrul Mu'mineen. If anybody came to Hazrat Umar and Hazrat Umar was busy, he would say, go to Khayril Mu'mineen. The Imam of the Masjid is Khayrul Mu'mineen. Besides Hazrat Umar, the main Imam was Hazrat Umar. He would say, go to Khayrul Mu'mineen. He'll sort it out for you. Go ask him. Speak to him. You know what else he did? The lanterns in Masjid al-Nabawi. Lamp, lights. He arranged in Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's time. In Hazrat Umar's time, he was the Imam of Masjid al-Nabawi. You know his ikram. كيف كان يكرم الناس؟ قال الذهبي. And the qissah is sahih, that a man comes to Medina by the name of Muawiyah bin Harmal, and he was from the Murtaddin, and he was a relative of Musaylima Kadhab, and he was very, very scared. He says, I come to Medina and I'm very scared. I must meet Hazrat Umar before he recognizes me, because I want to make Tawbah. But I caused havoc to the Muslims. So I come to Medina and I'm worried. And Hazrat Umar sees a new man. Who are you? Now look, another beautiful thing we learn. Sahaba would see new people and greet them and make them comfortable. So when we see new people, a new student, we should have this quality. Even in your masjid, you the imam, a new brother, meet him. Assalamu alaikum, brother. My name is so and so. What is your name? Where are you from? What can I do for you? Can I make your khidmah? This is the beauty of Islam. This man got worried, and Hazrat Umar had awe. He says, O Amir al-Mu'mineen, ta'ibun min qabli an taqdira alayhi. I'm a person repenting before you found me. I already came here. You didn't capture me anyway. I came here on my own. So Hazrat Umar says, fine. Who are you? Muawiyah bin Harmal. Hazrat Umar was so sharp, he knew. This was the murtad who was the relative. But now he's making tawbah. So obviously he's not murtad anymore. Alhamdulillah, he's back into Islam. But otherwise the murtad deen had caused a lot of taklif. Hazrat Abu Bakr and Umar were very upset with those who were renegade. Yeah, Hazrat Umar says, you go to Khairil Mu'mineen. So now he's wondering, who's Khairul Mu'mineen? So he's asking in the masjid. They tell him, they point to Tamim ad-Dari. But one person gave him good advice. You see a new man coming, tell him, this is the meal times, this is how you do it, this is Rahmat Bai, this is so-and-so, this is so-and-so. This is how you make people comfortable. Otherwise, a man will come first few days, nobody making his ikram, take him to your room for a cup of tea, make him comfortable. He could stay here for the next 7-8 years and you got the thawab because you made him comfortable. Otherwise, he came here, he's only seeing gloomy faces, he'll run away in the first month. That man could be a potential to change thousands of people. Show him akhlaq. You know what Hazrat Tamim used to do? So somebody advised him. You want to meet Khairul Mu'mineen? Just make salah next to him. Whoever makes salah next to him, you'll see what he'll do. He's going to take you home. So this man just made salah next to Hazrat Tamim ad-Dari. Hazrat Tamim ad-Dari never looked at color. Whoever was next to him, he just took them home. This is the beauty of Sahaba. He says, every day, I had my ikram sorted out. I just must make salah next to Tamim ad-Dari. I'm going to his house. Muawiyah says, one day, I'm sitting in Tamim Dari's house. And Hazrat Umar Ja'a. Ya Tamim, go and sort it out. Sort what out? There's a volcanic eruption. Qal al-Dhahabi sahih. There's a volcanic eruption from a volcano in Medina. And the lava, molten fire, is charging in the direction of Medina Munawwara. And as this fire is charging in Medina Munawwara, Hazrat Tamim is saying, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, what can I do? He says, I am ordering you. You just go and sort it out. Hazrat Tamim goes. He's charging. The fire is coming. He's going towards the fire. Melted fire. Hazrat Umar is behind him. I am behind both of them. And I just saw the way Hazrat Tamim angled that fire. He took that lava and he angled it and channeled it and took it back to the mountain it erupted from and returned it into its original source and made dua that it was covered forever. And you know what? Hazrat Umar made an announcement. He said, Laysa man ra'a kamal lam yara. If you saw this event of Allah's help, you can never be, one who didn't see it can never be like the one who saw it. Meaning seeing this karama of the sahabi was so spectacular, was so amazing. So this was Tamim ad-Dari. He was the imam of the masjid. So respected students, some of you are going to be making imamat everywhere, isn't it? It's not just imamat, lead your salah and go away home. No, you learn tarjama, you learn tafsir. Where you leading the prayer, deliberate over what you are reading. After the taraweeh, even when you imam of your masjid, don't just let the community go home without something. The only thing he goes home, mashallah, beautiful qari. That's not sufficient. Tell him, this is what we recited today. Surah Baqarah, Ujibu da'wat al-da'i idha da'an. Allah speaks of the fast. And under the discussion of the fast, Allah says, whatever dua you make is responded to. Allah says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ. Tell people some ayat so you can go home with knowledge and love for the Quran. So this month is for us to connect to the Quran and for us
to connect the world to the Quran. Really, I implore you, if you know the meaning of the Quran and you've studied the meaning of the Quran and you do not share the message with other people, the people are reading behind you. Even if they're reading 3 rak'at, you know how they are suffering. They don't understand. You are enjoying it, inshallah, because you understand. That man who doesn't understand. Now, after that, you didn't give him some message to go home with. You know what? Can I tell you something? That is selfish of you. It is selfish. You let him go home and you didn't let him go home with some knowledge of the beautiful Quran. It is selfish. His legs are paining. His feet are paining. And you let him go home just like that. He didn't understand anything. It's not fair. So, أيها القراء والحفظة والطلاب العلم, make sure where you're leading the Taraweeh. You share with the community. Even if it's a short message, that this ayah I want to share with you today. And then you encourage him. Uncle, respected friends, when you go home, this is the chapter, this is the ayah. Please look it up. Then you are connecting him to the Quran. You connect him to the Quran. Then you teach him more. So you're going through a journey with Allah. You're going close to Allah and you are connecting your community with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And maybe you are in first year, but you're a hafiz, but you don't know the tarjama, and you haven't studied the tafsir, then you can't play fools with the Quran Kareem. So what you do? Fada'il A'mal and Hayatul Sahaba. And you share something with the community. Fada'il Ramadan. So they can also be uplifted spiritually. We all will try, inshallah. This beautiful hadith, you must read it. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Istakthiru fihi min arba'i khisal. In Ramadan, do a lot of 4 things. Khaslatain turduna bihima rabbakum. Wa khaslatain la ghina'a bikum anhuma. 2 things you'll make Allah happy with. And 2 things you can't do without. The 2 things you'll make Allah happy with is la ilaha illallah wa tastaghfiruna. Start from now, every day. La ilaha illallah, hundreds of times. Istighfar, hundreds of times. And the second thing, la ghina'a bikum anhuma. You can't do without. Salman's hadith, radiyallahu anhu. Is تسألون الله الجنة وتستعيذون به من النار. Beg Allah, beseech Allah for Jannah for you and for humanity, and beg Allah to save us from Jahannam. And in our du'as, it should be there all the time. Du'a for our brothers and sisters in Gaza. Allah give us tawfiq.